Now that we have a clear sense of what a syntactic entailment is, what a proof is, and we have the general outline of the deductive apparatus, the next thing to look at is how to solve proofs. And one of the steps towards solving proofs is setting the proof up. So let's take a look at an example. Here we have a syntactic entailment, that is, P and R, if Y then R, entail Z. So what this says is that Z is a syntactic consequence or is entailed by P and R, if Y, then R. In other words, there is a derivation or proof beginning with P wedge R, Y right arrow R, that will, through a sort of sequence of steps using the deductive apparatus, we can ultimately conclude in Z. The question is, well, how do we show this derivation? How do we actually do the proof? How do we fill in the middle part, that is, the formulas necessary that concludes with Z? So here we'll look at how to set the proof up, and in later videos I'll look at how to kind of fill in these middle steps. So first, a derivation or proof begins with initial setup, and we'll take a particular approach that makes use of three main columns. The first column just is listing the formulas or premises or any of the lines in the proof itself. This will be helpful just so we can refer back to them if we need to talk about them, and then also just for reference sake if we have to refer back to them because we make use of a particular rule of reasoning or rule of inference and we want to say, oh, I used line 2 and line 4, formula 3 or formula 6. The second major column is this column that's going to consist only of formulas. This is strictly speaking the key component of a proof, because we said a proof is just a string of formulas, and this middle column is just going to kind of be this string of formula, but we're going to kind of create this vertical column of formulas. The third column is the justification of the formulas in the proof. And if we need any kind of heuristic formulas, any notes we want to write to ourselves to kind of say, okay, this is the goal at this point in the proof. This column is indicating how that particular formula at its respective line, how it got there. Is it a premise? Is it an assumption? Is it a result of prior formulas and some specific rule of reason that we made use of? So let's look at an example. Of how to set up a proof. We'll take the previous example where we said it's capable of being proved that from P wedge R, Y right arrow R, that Z follows. So essentially what we're saying here is we can start with the formulas P and R, Y right arrow R, and use the deductive apparatus to reason to Z. Because we're saying it's entailed by those formulas, so there should be a proof of this using the deductive apparatus. So the way that we'll show this is we'll start with the formulas P and R and put it on one line, and then Y right arrow R and put it on a separate line. Now if we had more premises, we would put it on line 3 and 4 and 5. And if we had fewer, let's say we just had P and R, we would only put P and R on line 1. In addition to this, we'll want to number these formulas. We'll want to number every formula that we introduce into the proof. Here we just have two formulas that serve as our reason or premises, or the formulas that are provided or the ones that we're starting with. So we'll label P and R 1 and Y right arrow R 2. So in addition to writing the formulas down and numbering each formula in the proof, we'll also want to indicate how that formula got to the place it did, what justifies it. And we'll do this in the third column. Since both of these formulas are provided for us, since both of them are premises, we'll simply use P to indicate that it's a premise or it's a provided formula. In addition, in the third column, we can make use of any heuristic devices, notes, or, as I'll do sometimes, indicate the goal proposition. Here I write comma Z, and I write Z to indicate the goal of the proof is Z. This is where I want to use the deductive apparatus and the formulas in the proof to reason to. And once I'm able to write Z justifiably in the middle column, then I'll know to stop and my proof will be completed. So once again, setting up the proof is relatively straightforward. You simply stack or write in a column all of the formulas that you're provided, number them, and then indicate in the third column that that formula is provided. And in addition, you'll want to write any notes to yourself or just the goal formula in that third column as well.